Well, up first, news of the vaccine in India and the results of the phase one trial of the COVID vaccine candidate Covaxin, developed by Bharat Biotech, have shown that the vaccine induced an immune response and did not lead to any serious side effects. Now, this is according to a preprint study published by Bharat Biotech. This has not been peer reviewed, which means it hasn't been reviewed by a third party. The data has not been reviewed by a third party. The vaccine is currently in phase three trials in India and has applied for emergency use authorization. However, for the vaccine to receive usage approval from the Indian drug regulator, a lot more data would be needed on its safety and efficacy percentage, which is calculated on the basis of combined analysis of phase one and phase two results, or all the three phases together. And staying with news on the Bharat Biotech vaccine, the AIIMS doctor who's in charge of the vaccine trial there has said that for the third phase of the Bharat Biotech vaccine, Covaxin, for which they need thousands of people to volunteer, there's a 70 to 80% reduction in those volunteering. He says with the expectation of a vaccine around the corner, volunteers are dropping out. Listen into what he says.
Phase one, phase two mein definitely utsaah zyada tha. उत्साह अब भी है, बट वो दूसरे टाइप का उत्साह है. फेज़ वन में हमने 100 वॉलंटियर्स की ज़रूरत थी. हमने एडवर्टाइज़ किया, विद इन 3-4 डेज हमारे पास करीब 4,500 के आसपास अप्लीकेंट ने अप्लाई किया. हमने फिर 4-5 दिन बाद बंद कर दिया था रजिस्ट्रेशन, क्योंकि बार बार कॉल आ रहे थे कि आपने हमें नहीं बुलाया. फेज़ टू में भी ऐसा ही रहा. फेज़ थ्री में भी पार्टिसिपेंट्स आ रहे हैं, लेकिन फेज़ थ्री में तो पार्टिसिपेंट्स आ रहे हैं, उत्साहित हैं कि उनको वैक्सीन लगेगी, लेकिन जब आ रहे हैं तो हमें पूरी इन्फॉर्मेशन देनी होती है कि इट्स ए क्लिनिकल ट्रायल. क्लिनिकल ट्रायल में उनको हम बताते हैं, पूरी इन्फॉर्मेशन जब देते हैं कि आपको वैक्सीन भी लग सकता है, आपको प्लेसबो मिल सकता है. सो 50% चांस है कि आपको प्लेसबो मिलेगा, 50% चांस है कि आपको वैक्सीन मिलेगा. ये जानने के बाद मेजॉरिटी ऑफ हमारे जो पार्टिसिपेंट्स आ रहे हैं वो कह रहे हैं कि अभी तो वैक्सीन आने वाली है तो हम फिर उसी में पार्टिसिपेट करें, क्यों ट्रायल में पार्टिसिपेट करें, वैक्सीन तो जल्दी ही आने वाली है, विद इन हफ्ते 10 डेज में आ सकती है. तो ये कह के जो है रिफ्यूजल रेट काफ़ी ज़्यादा है, जो कि रिफ्यूजल रेट पहले नहीं था हमारा इतना. रिफ्यूजल रेट हार्डली फेज़ वन फेज़ टू में देखें तो एटलीस्ट मैं अपने यहाँ कह सकता हूँ कि लेस देन 10% था. इस समय 70-80% के आसपास रिफ्यूजल रेट आ रहा है, तो रिफ्यूजल रेट्स बहुत ही हाई है. हमें जो हमारा टारगेट था कि बाई एंड ऑफ दिस मंथ दिसंबर 1,000 to 1,500 हमें पार्टिसिपेंट्स को रिक्रूट करना है, बट इतने हाई रिफ्यूजल पे हम रोज 100 बुलाते हैं और 20 के आसपास रिक्रूटमेंट हो रहा है. अराउंड 200 के आसपास अभी तक रिक्रूटमेंट हमारा हो पाया है. सो हम उसको एक्सपेडाइट करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, अभी फिर से हम उसको एडवर्टाइज करने जा रहे हैं.
Well, to talk more about this vaccine news, we're now joined by Dr. Sunila Garg, Director and Professor of Community Medicine, Maulana Azad Medical College, also a fellow WHO and advisor to the ICMR. Thank you so much, Dr. Garg, for joining us on the show. First and foremost, about this study that has been published about the phase one trial of the Bharat Biotech vaccine. What is your reaction to that? This is not something that has been peer reviewed yet, and there's no efficacy result in it yet.
Yeah. The phase one trial basically is supposed to look for the safety part, and the immunogenicity is the second part of that. So you see, by, you know, if the encouraging results are there, which have been there in phase one, but on the basis of phase one, then we go to phase two trial, which already, you know, this Bharat Biotech vaccine is undergoing phase two trial also, and which has been cut short. Looking at the results from phase one, that means it is quite safe. And it is also immunogenically is quite good. So that's why we are going into phase two trial, in which we are, you know, we are phase three trial now. Looking at the encouraging results of phase one and phase two, which is going to be conducted in over about 26,000 individuals. And also we are going to do this trial at about 25 sites. That is the important part of it. So, but one thing which I will make very clearly over here is that as a public health person, that this is a vaccine where we have to look for safety, immunogenicity, efficacy, everything together. Safety is the most important concern. So vaccine is important in its own place. But one thing which gives us, you know, assurance is that this is backed by experts from Indian Council of Medical Research and National Institute of Virology as well.
Right, ma'am. Now, ma'am, a lot of the, you know, researchers and scientists and doctors have raised issue questions about why there hasn't been more data forthcoming regarding these trials by Bharat Biotech. Now this phase one that has taken place earlier, now the data has been published, though of course it has been submitted to authorities, and currently Bharat Biotech, the Covaxin, is one of the vaccines under consideration for emergency use authorization.
Yeah, definitely this is one of the issues which, you know, has to be fulfilled before you see the vaccine rolls out. So all the conditions have to be fulfilled. That is, there is no cut short on these procedures, and we need to look at all the processes. So right now we have got the data of phase one, which, as I told you, which basically talks about the efficacy, but as a secondary endpoint, it also showed us about the immunogenicity part. That means its effectivity part. So as a result of which we went into phase two, for which, you know, the vaccine also showed that it is quite, you know, effective, where we looked at the effectivity part. And based on this, we cut short the phase two. But then we are looking for the formal paper out of it.
And ma'am, do you feel there's been enough transparency? Because a few researchers have, you know, spoken about this opacity in terms of getting information, getting data regarding the vaccines. Not just Bharat Biotech, even the studies of the Oxford vaccine, which are being done by the Serum Institute. There's not enough information about the phase three trials here in India, while there is information about the studies that have taken place abroad.
You see, those studies, I'll say that many studies started much earlier. We have to see that when we look at Moderna or Pfizer vaccines and all that, they started a little earlier as compared to this. But you see, gradually this data also will be made available. It takes time for the publication part of also. But I will also say that from the public health perspective, it is important to look at all these documents. That's why, you know, we have gone into phase three. And though you see emergency authorization has been applied, but we have to look for the complete data sets in terms of safety, efficacy, and, you know, sustainability, because we have to look for, you know, the long-term effects of the vaccine. So we are not going to hurry up with regard to, and we should not hurry up.
Right, ma'am. And speaking of the phase three trials that are underway, this unusual problem in AIIMS, they're not getting enough volunteers to come forward because people feel like the vaccine is just around the corner. Why should they go for a trial in which they may be given a placebo?
Yeah, this is where I feel that, you know, we have got a very important role to play from the perspective of media and, you know, as scientists, so that, you know, people know that what trial is all about. So, you know, so much has gone, you know, about into talking about the vaccines. So it is important that the people understand that they are volunteers. They can be enrolled into any arm of this thing, and we have to blind them so that we can get, you know, equal results from the both who are getting the vaccines and who are not getting the vaccines. So I can understand the person's concerns also, because everybody wants to get the vaccine. That is also another important thing which we have to, you know, kind of understand. So I feel that this will be a challenge in phase three, but we have to overcome this challenge by having patience and by having very good counselors who are going to explain to the participants that this is how the vaccine is going to come out, and this is the basic purpose of the trial, because that is how we are enrolling volunteers into the trial.
Right. In fact, we're showing visuals of those posters that are outside AIIMS that actually are asking people to come forward for the trial. Thank you so much, Dr. Sunila Garg, for speaking to us.
Thank you.